Good afternoon, YouTube. Taming the Tamaskan with you guys today. So today we're going to do a Tug leash review. So the Tug leash is another retractable leash through which I have purchased myself through Amazon. And it's an awesome looking leash. As you know, I like to use retractable leashes, especially when I'm hiking in areas where I want Taylor to have a little bit more freedom than just her 4 foot leash that I use in stores. So, but here recently, we've just kind of been looking at different leashes and other things. The Dogness leash broke. So that's kind of a bummer, although I haven't done an update video because the leash broke because of my fault more than anything. We were hiking somewhere and the leash got pulled out of my hand on some rocks and stuff, and it got smashed. I mean, truthfully, it really wasn't the leash's fault. It just broke from getting smashed real hard. I actually really still do like the Dogness leashes. But I figured since Tug is rated really well, and the thing that Tug, I think, is more known for, even just than their retractable leashes, is their customer service. So going through Amazon, it's easy to see that their customer service is fantastic. You know, anybody who has a complaint, it's always the same story where the company reached out to me and replaced the leash within a few days. That's pretty good. Looking at the box, just your basic things for retractable leash stuff. Free movement, shouldn't tangle, easy lock system. The lock systems on all these are almost all the same. This, of course, is the large, which is rated for a 110-pound dog, which Taylor's right around. Taylor's right at about 100 pounds. All right. First thing that happens is you pull out this little slip of paper here. Might be hard to read, but I'll go ahead and read it out loud. But leash is not chew-proof. Chew prevention strap in the box mitigates chewing risk to some extent. Please try to watch your dog prevent chewing when using the strap. Do not use if damaged. Do not allow your dog to sprint from start to end of the line. So, normal retractable leash things. And if you're new to dogs, I trained Taylor from puppy with a retractable leash, but I found with other dogs it may not be the best idea to do so. More than likely, it's best to loose leash with something like a 4 foot leash and then move on to a retractable leash. In the box, they include, like they say, this leash extender, so if they chew on it, it doesn't destroy your main retractable leash. That's kind of nice. Although Taylor doesn't really chew on leashes anymore, so it's not a problem. And then we have the good old Tug. I'm still not, I mean, it is definitely pretty beefy. When you look at this thing, it's pretty massive, as it probably should be. So standard kind of retractable leash. This is definitely beefy, the handle. If you've got a large dog and you're a small female, this handle probably is not going to be comfortable for you. Even in my hand, this thing feels massive. I don't have large hands as a dude, but it's definitely not small. That being said, if you got a large dog, sometimes you got to work with yourself on that. The button is also huge. I like this so far. We'll see in practice. It's very smooth. I like that when it's retracted all the way in that I can lock it, because I like to hang these up on a hook at home. So yeah, this being able to lock right at, sometimes with other leashes I had to pull it out a little bit to lock it, and yeah, so that's kind of nice. The mechanism doesn't sound overly noisy like the good to go leashes from Petco. Although it is noisier than the Dogness leash. One problem I always had with the Dogness leash is that their anti-tangle mechanism in the front to keep the band from twisting doesn't work very well. It will occasionally get twisted up, which was never fun. So just kind of locking it and tugging on it a little bit. Pun intended. Standard kind of lock. And then if you're tugging on it, can you release it? Nope, still have to release tension, like all of these, which makes sense. But I actually kind of like this, the way that this rolls forward and backwards is super easy. We'll definitely have to see this, how this works in real life. My final initial thoughts on the Tug so far is for It's quality feel of plastics, and it's got some a little bit of rubberization to it. Feels pretty good, especially for, you know, right around the $20 point on Amazon. I still think the Flexi feels more premium. The Flexis are heavier for sure. And yeah, we'll see how it holds up. Taylor, now that she's a lot better trained, is probably not nearly as hard on these as she used to be. But nonetheless, containing a 100-pound wolf dog when she's trying to take off is not the easiest thing in the world. Also, I didn't mention it before, but it's a standard 16-foot leash size. Most of these are 16 feet. Occasionally, you'll find them advertised as 20 feet. But yeah, this is pretty good. I like the at the front here. I like this plastic covering where the stitching is. This seems pretty durable. A lot of times on retractable leashes, I have these break or shatter or whatever else, just because you're doing a lot of flexing around. It's opening and closing a lot, and this seems to be one of the things that wear out, and then I get fraying right at the stitching. So, but this this tape is definitely wider than a lot of other leashes I find. Definitely wider than the Dogness leash.
Oh, not too bad about you. She is friendly. Taylor. How you doing? Go, go. Wait, stay. Okay. Well, guys, this is quite possibly one of my favorite spots in Colorado Springs, Mount Muskoka. Great 2 mile hike, and I think it's thousands of feet, or a 1400 feet climb in altitude or something like that, maybe more. I'll throw it up on the screen. Awesome hike though. So a few years ago at least, I came up here with Taylor, and of course, being a puppy, I didn't want to hurt her joints or nothing. She got real tired real quick up on the climb, so she rode on my backpack pretty much the whole way up. And that was awesome. Probably one of my more favorite memories with Taylor as a very young puppy. She came up here with me though. I tell you what, this leash has been pretty awesome though. If I'm being perfectly honest, I've been pretty happy with this. It's a little on the heavy side, but it's very good in the hand. The locking mechanism is great. The only issue that I have is sometimes with gloves, I can't feel the lock. But I guess I can't expect everybody to make these with gloves in mind. Otherwise, the mechanism's nice, and now that Taylor is pretty well trained, I don't really worry about pulling too much. Be easy. Wait. Stay. Good girl. That's the biggest key to training on a retractable leash, is having good control over the dog, so that way she can listen and stop when I need her to, and not, you know, run out the strand and jerk me, because in these types of situations, it's pretty dangerous. Nice and easy. Easy, easy. Stay. 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 Come on. Come on. Taylor. Easy, easy. Stay. 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 Good girl. Yeah, you are fantastic. You know that dog?
Okay, guys, after a few days of using the tug leash, and we did a pretty long 6.5-ish mile hike with it, and we've been out quite a bit with this leash. Very impressed with it, actually. It's been very good. I would say that it's a little bit on the heavier side, and I think the ergonomics as a whole are it's definitely meant for someone with a large hand. They kind of assume, I guess, if you have a large dog, you've got large hands, and that's, I think, my really my only big complaint about it is holding it, even with my I would say normal sized male hands, it's a very large leash, and it shows. But it also is pretty well built. I dropped it a few times. It got drug on rocks a little bit. Doesn't even really have a whole lot of scratches to show for it. I like that the tape's a little bit thicker than some others. And it's holding up pretty well so far. I think it's done pretty good. I would totally recommend it at the price point. I think that they're about $20-ish on Amazon right now. So that's a pretty good deal. If you roll into PetSmart or Petco and you're looking at a Flexi or something, they're generally like $35 or $40, I think. So these, I think, are a better value than a Flexi. Although I think the quality is probably about the same. I like the button quite a bit in the end. This the way that this locks and unlocks is it's very big. It's easy to manipulate the actual button itself with gloves on. The lock, I found that with my particular gloves, I just had issues, and I think that's just a me struggling in life there. Otherwise, I think I'm gonna go ahead and say that I would totally recommend this product as a leash. I mean, it holds on to Taylor's 100 pounds, no problem. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed some of the hiking footage I threw in here. I wanted to show a little bit more of actually using a leash, or how I use a retractable leash with Taylor when we go out hiking. Generally, when we go in stores and stuff, I've talked about it in the past, I use a 4-foot leash, loose leash, kind of walking with her around in stores and whatnot. But we go hiking, I like to have, at least a 16-foot leash so Taylor can kind of explore around a little bit. It also helps in some areas. where I need her to go ahead or stop or whatever else. So it's all about what you train your dog to do. I know some people aren't a huge fan of these leashes. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and what other retractable leashes you'd like to see reviewed, or other leashes in general. I'm always up to trying out new things. So I'll catch you all next time.